Hey guys, Tennessee Yankee, thanks for joining. Hey, I am going to use my Tomahawk stump bucket today. I have only tried using this once to remove a small stump when I got it last fall and haven't really had a use for it until today. As you can see, it's just been sitting down here in the woods collecting some leaves, but I'm gonna go ahead and use it. I need to transplant a tree that's in my way right now, a small crepe myrtle that I have out front, and I'm redoing some of the pitch of the landscape out there. So I need to move it right now because I'm gonna be raising up the fill quite a bit. So I'm gonna go ahead and hook this up. I'm gonna dig a hole down here with it and then kind of approximate what I might need for the temporary transplant down here. So let's get after it. So I'll give you some dimensions for this Tomahawk stump bucket, but I just kind of wanted to show you a little bit about it. It's got the four teeth in the front, and then it's got this kind of aggressive, sharp root, jagged edge there that we can kind of use to dig around the roots. I found the first time I used it, this thing is pretty heavy duty. I think it would be well more suited for like a, at least a, you know, 40 horsepower tractor or maybe the skid steer itself. So I'm probably going to end up getting a little bit of use out of this, and I may end up selling this and using that money towards a grapple, which I'll get a lot more use out of. I just don't see myself using this quite as much as I thought I would, but it seems like it's well built. And then of course this has the skid steer quick connect on the back, made in the USA. So let's get it hooked up. All right, guys, so you can kind of see the angle there. The reason I said maybe a bigger tractor is that I just find that this thing is seems quite large and stout for this this loader, but we'll see how it goes when I start digging a hole. But before we get started with that, I did want to give you those measurements. So overall, this thing is from that back corner to this tip up here, we got 45 inches. And then if I was to measure the back center to the front of the tooth, it's 41 and a quarter inches. As far as the width in the back, obviously it's about the width of the quick connect, but it's 45 inches in the back. And then the width in the front is about 14 inches. So this piece right here appears to be 3/8 inch steel. Yep, 3/8. Let's see what other measurements. I guess these serrations, they go about 2 inches deep. But yeah, so let's go ahead. I'm gonna try to dig a hole with this thing and figure out where I want to temporarily transplant my bush. Okay, I think this is going to be the spot I'm going to go with. There used to be a bunch of trees kind of around this area, so hopefully I won't get too many stumps, but I need an area that's kind of open, and this is it. So we'll try to dig around a little bit and see what we come up with. Okay, no filter with the Yankee. So obviously I didn't think this through very well. Even though this is kind of an open area, there's still a fairly decent sized tree right here. So that's not the smartest place to dig, because I'm certainly just digging up some of those existing roots. So I'm gonna change course here, find a different spot. It's gonna be kind of tough down here in the woods, but I guess we're giving it a little workout. Okay guys, what do you think? I might take the easy route down here, and since this is temporary, I think I might just start digging into that bank a little bit, because everywhere I go down here in the flat just has so many old roots that I would have taken trees out in this area. Now, there's still those two trees there, but I think if I go right in the middle here and dig into the hill a little bit, I should be able to find some, you know, temporary spot. I'm probably only looking to have it here for a few weeks. Okay, guys, that's not the prettiest. You can kind of see it struggling a little bit there. Part of the problem is I don't have enough. Well, first I'm on a little bit of a hill, have this tree stump in my way. And then I don't have my ballast on because I'm using my rake. So I didn't really want to change out my ballast, but you can kind of see I'm digging a decent little hole with it. You just got to kind of really take your time. But, you know, on the hill here and without enough weight, I'm kind of struggling with the four-wheel drive. But, you know, I don't even know how big of a hole I need yet. This is pretty decent. It's a little bit of a mess right now, but I might take a few more passes at it just to try to clean the hole out. But then I can just kind of set the root ball down in there, and I think that'll hold her over for a little bit. Guys, I think that's a decent hole for what we're doing right now. I was really struggling here to try to get that last angle because I got this stump in my way right here. So it's hard to get all my tires grounded well. But yeah, that dug a hole pretty decent. All right, let's go back and try to get this crepe myrtle out. Okay, let's see if we can't get this thing popped out. Row easy on me. I'm an amateur. All right, boys and girls. I don't know that it was pretty, but we got it. That came out pretty decent. You can see though that it is a struggle with this guy. But man, beats a shovel, don't it? So I guess I'll throw some straps on it or something just to make sure I can get it down the woods. And then we'll stick her down there and I can get to excavating up here again. Okay, I just got one strap around it, tied down here. I think that'll make the trip down to the woods. We'll find out. Four-wheel drive, headed down the hill. For the vibration, Yankee ain't got any fancy camera equipment. This is being filmed on a Samsung Note 9 from 2018. Almost feel like we're gonna make the whole trip. This guy was planted in 2019. It's been in the ground for 4 years. There's our hole, which is probably kind of big. I'm going to unstrap this thing. But hey, we made it. Praise the Lord. If I can take some tension off. Okay, guys, I don't think that's too bad for amateur Yankee. So I think that hill worked out okay. Got her backfilled. Starting to rain like crazy, so we're missing that being down in the woods. All right, guys, thanks for watching. If you found this helpful, go ahead and hit that like button. I'd love it if you can subscribe. And I do want to do a shout out. It'll probably be, I don't know, a few weeks before I get this video up, but the channel hit over 1,000 subscribers in May. So I really appreciate all you tuning in, all your subscriptions, and all your likes, and we'll see you on the next one. Thanks, guys. Hey guys, Tennessee Yankee. Thanks for watching. If you found this content helpful, go ahead and hit that subscribe button on your right. I have other content linked for you on the left side. Otherwise, we'll see you next time. Thanks again for watching.